Dear students, in this module, we are going to learn data analysis with Python and Pandas using Jupyter Notebook. You will learn how to prepare data for analysis, perform simple statistical analysis, create meaningful data visualizations, predict future trends from data and more. Data plays an important role in our lives. The entire world is roaming around huge data. Every piece of data is precious as it may affect the business organization which is using that data. So, we need some mechanism to store that data. Once the data is stored, we should be able to retrieve it based on some prerequisites. For example, a business company wants to know about how much amount they had spent in the last 1 year on purchasing the raw material. Such data cannot be easily retrieved from the huge data available. We have to retrieve the data as per the needs of the business organization. This is called data analysis or data analytics, where the data that is retrieved will be analyzed to answer the questions raised by the management of the organization. The libraries you will need for any scientific computations and data analysis are NumPy, stands for numerical Python. The most powerful feature of NumPy is n-dimensional array. This library also contains basic linear algebra functions. SciPy stands for scientific Python. SciPy is built on NumPy. It is one of the most useful library for variety of high-level science and engineering. Modules like discrete Fourier transform, linear algebra, optimization and sparse matrices. Pandas for structured data operations and manipulations. It is extensively used for data mining and preparation. Scikit-learn for machine learning built on NumPy, SciPy and Matplotlib. This library contains a lot of efficient tools for machine learning, statistical modeling, including classification, regression, clustering, and dimensionality reduction. ScrapPy for web crawling. It is a very useful framework for patterns of data. It has the capability to start at a website, home URL, and then dig through web pages within the website to gather information. Pandas is one of the most useful data analysis library in Python. It contains high-level data structures and manipulation tools to make data analysis fast and easy in Python. To install Jupyter, all you have to do is run the pip command python-m pip install Jupyter. Then, to run the program, open your terminal in the folder where you would like to store your notebooks and just run Jupyter Notebook. That command will initialize a server in your computer and redirect your favorite browser to it. From there, just use the GUI to create a new notebook and open it. Two key data structures in Pandas are series and data frames. Series can be a one-dimensional labeled or indexed array. You can access individual elements of this series through these labels. This one-dimensional array defined in Pandas can be used to store any data type. Data frame is an object that is useful in representing data in the form of rows and columns. It is two-dimensional data structure defined in pandas, which consists of rows and columns. For example, the data may come from a file or an Excel spreadsheet or from a Python sequence like a list or tuple. We can represent that data in the form of a data frame. Once the data is stored into the data frame, we can perform various operations that are useful in analyzing and understanding the data. Data frames are generally created from CSV files, Excel spreadsheet files, Python dictionaries. Series and data frames form the core data model for pandas in Python. The data sets are first read into these data frames, and then various operations like group by, aggregation, etc. can be applied very easily to its columns. Let us create data frame from an Excel spreadsheet. Assume that student data file contains data related to student roll number, name, date of birth, department, and marks. To create the data frames, we should first import the pandas package. We are in need of XLRD package that is useful in extracting data from Excel files. To read the data from Excel file, we should use read Excel function of pandas package. Open command prompt and run pip in user mode by adding --- user option when installing with pipe, which typically install the package to the local appdata Python folder. Open the Python IDLE window and type the commands as to import pandas and numpy. The commands are import pandas as pd, import numpy as np. To display the version of pandas, the command to be used is print pd.version_. Jupyter notebooks are just that same environment on steroids. It's like running the Python console tool for a read, eval, print loop, but with a cute interface and the ability to document and save what you tested. It is a conventional to refer to pandas as pd. When you add the as pd at the end of your import statement, your Jupyter notebook understands that from this point on, every time you type pd, you are actually referring to the pandas library. Let us see the command to check the pandas version. Print pd.version_. The output will be 0.22.0. To work with series data structure in pandas, let us assign data variable with values and then use series method. Initialize data with 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, and 9. Now assign S with pd.series of data. If you display S, the output will be 0, 11, 32, 43, 54, 65, 2, 6, 9, and the data type is int 64. Next, move on to indexing series data. Here, two parameters are data and index. Let us assign index with ABCDEFG, and SI is initialized with pd.series of data, index. Now, if you display SI, the output will be A with 1, B with 3, C with 4, etc. And the data type is int 64. Here the data is initialized with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and SND is assigned with pd.series of data. If you display SND value, the output will be 0 of 2, 3, 4 and 1 of 5, 6, 7 and the corresponding data type is object. To work with data frames, let us assign A to data frame of data variable. So, A is equivalent to pd.dataframe of data. Now, if we display A, the output will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 2, 3, 4, 1, 5, 6, 7. Next, we are going to discuss about how to read contents from CSV file. Now, the data is assigned with pd.readCSV of the file name. Here, the file name is 1.csv. So, if you display the data, the output will be the names, high score and unnamed parameter. So, the names will be starts from that is MEL and the high scores will be 8. Like that, the value will be displayed which will be stored in the variable called data. Let us discuss about the data analysis. From pandas, import data frame. Read CSV, import matplotlib pyplot as PIT, import pandas as PD, file is initialized with 1.csv and DF is assigned with pd.readcsv of the specified file. Here we are going to print the max value with the help of DF of highscore.max function. And min value with the help of df of iscore.min function. So, the output will be max 9 and min 3. If you want to display only column headings, then the commands will be df is equivalent to pd.readcsv of the file name. Here the file name is 1.csv. Then print column headings with the help of df.columns. Column headings, index of names, high score, unnamed. So, the data type will be object. Next, we are going to work with iris datasheet. Df is equivalent to pd.readcsv of iris.csv. If you display df, the output is all the rows in the iris data set will be displayed. To display only 5 rows of data, the command to be used is df.head method. The output is the first 5 rows of iris data set will be displayed. To display only last 5 rows of data, the command to be used is df.tail method. The output is the last 5 rows in the iris data set will be displayed, 144 to 148. To display only 5 rows of data, the command to be used is df.sample of s. The output is to display any 5 rows of data, the command to be used is next. We are going to see how to get only columns from iris dataset. Import pandas as PD. From pandas, import Excel writer. From pandas, import Excel file. Then assign DF with pd.readcsv of iris.csv file. Then print df.columns. The output is all the columns in the iris data set. For example, sepal length, sepal width, petal width, species. And the data type is equivalent to object will be displayed. Next, we are going to see how to get only columns from student data data set. So for that, import pandas as PD, from pandas import Excel writer, from pandas import Excel file. Now initialize df with pd.readExcel of studentdata.xlsx, and sheet name is initialized with sheet 1. Here we are going to display the column headings by including the command print of df.columns. The output is column headings, roll number, name, DOB, date of birth, department, mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, and the data type is here object. Then if you want to display the department data only, the command to be used is print df of department, DEPT. The output is 0 CSE, 1 CSE, 2 AAA likewise, and the data type is object. The command to display only department column is for I in df.index colon print df of department of I. So the output is all the departments in the data set will be printed. To display the department value in index 0, the command will be, so list department is equivalent to df of DEPT. So print list DEPT of 0, then the output is CSE. That is in column 0, the department name is CSE, so it will be printed. To display the different fields in student data set, the command to be used is import pandas as PD, from pandas import Excel writer, from pandas import Excel file. DF is assigned with pd.readExcel of studentdata.xlsx, and sheet name is initialized with sheet 1. Student name is initialized with DF of name. Student date of birth is initialized with DF of DOB. Student department is initialized with DF of DEPT. Now, if you display student name, then all the student names will be displayed and the data type is object. If you display student date of birth, then date of birth of each and every student will be displayed. Here the data type is date time 64. If you display student department, all the students department column will be displayed on the screen. Here the data type is object. Next, we are going to discuss about how to write contents into Excel file. Import pandas as PD, from pandas import Excel writer, from pandas import Excel file, import numpy as np, df, then pd dot data frame of a is initialized with some of the values and b is initialized with some of the values. Now I'm going to write these contents into Excel file by using the command Excel writer of 2.xlsx, and it is initialized to writer object. Now I am going to call 2Excel method of writer with sheet 1 and index is equivalent to false. Then writer.save method. So once if this command is gets executed, then the corresponding Excel file will be created. Pandas has several methods that allow you to quickly analyze a data set and get an idea of the type and amount of data you are dealing with, along with some important statistics. Shape, it returns the row and column count of a data set. Describe method returns statistics about the numerical columns in a data set. Dtypes method returns the data type of each column. Let us see how to use shape method. Df dot shape. So it will display the output as 11, 2, the number of rows and number of columns. Now it's time to work with describe method. Df dot describe method. So the count of A and B, then mean, some statistical information about mean, standard deviation STD, minimum value, 25 percentile, that will be 75% and as well as 50% maximum value will be displayed on the screen. Now have a look at dtypes method. df.dtypes. So then the data type of A and B variable will be displayed. A is of type int 64, B is of type int 64 and D type is object. Dear students, in this module we discussed about how to create data set and how to analyze data using Pandas and Jupyter Notebook. So to use Pandas and Jupyter Notebook, first you have to understand how to initialize this Pandas and Jupyter Notebook environment into your machine. So we discussed about that also. Next we discussed about how to work with Excel worksheet and how to create or how to read the contents from Excel worksheet and how to write the contents into Excel worksheet. And if some of the data are available in Excel worksheet as a column, then we discussed about how to retrieve the column information and the two different data structures used in Pandas. For example, series and another one is data frame data set. So how to work with these two types of data sets we discussed in this module. So I hope you enjoyed this module. Thank you and see you again in another module.